Which page are you on for Qasas? Chapter 13. What's chapter 30 for homework?
No.
Okay, I'm just reading to make sure I know all the words. Okay, Bismillah, inshallah. So let's read together chapter 13. Ru'ya al-Malik. What's a ru'ya? Ru'ya means actually a sight, but ru'ya is often also used for a sight in dreams, for a dream. So ru'ya al-Malik means the dream of the king. Let's read the first sentence. وَرَآ مَلِكُ مِصْرَ رُؤْيًا عَجِيبًا رُؤْيَا عَجِيبَةً وَرَآ is translated inshallah all together. And so مَلِكُ مِصْرَ, the king of Egypt. Remember مِصْرَ, if it's غَيْر مُنْصَرِف it means Egypt, if it's مِصْرِن it means a city. So we have to be مَلِكُ مِصْرِن to mean the king of a city, but مَلِكُ مِصْرَ means the king of Egypt. And the king of Egypt saw what? Ru'ya ajibatan.
Amazing dream.
Strange. An amazing, can be amazing or mean strange. Amazing or strange dream. Let's read inshallah. Ra'a fil manami sab'a baqaratin simanin. Ra'a. He saw fil manam. In his sleep, in his noam. In his sleep, he saw what he saw. He saw. Sab'a baqaratin. Seven fat cows. Let's read the next one together, inshallah. وَيَأْكُلُ هَذِهِ الْبَقَرَاتِ سَبْعُ بَقَرَاتٍ إِجَابًا. I think there's a mistake there. It should be sab'a or sab'u. Why? Why must be sab'a? Okay, let's read inshallah. وَيَأْكُلُ
and
eat. Where's the fa'il for eat?
It's sab'u.
The fat cows ate the fat cows, right? So in other words, so an example here, we have two parts. We have هذه البقرات, which means these cows, and then we have seven بقرات عجاف, seven thin cows. So how do you work out the فاعل? Can هذه البقرات be a فاعل? Why not? Because it is? How do you look in general? Baqarati. Is it in rough form? It would be looking like hadin. If the first part here to be fa'il, it would have been hadihil baqaratu. You know, because the thing after hadi, but the al follows the hal of the hadi. So if the hadi had to be raf'un, then the thing after the hadi would have been raf'un, because it is a musharun ilay. Remember, hadha. If the thing after it has an al, then whatever the hadha was, the hal of it, then the thing after it will be the same. For example, if hadha is in rafa, it will be hadha al-baytu. Hadha is in nasbun, hadha al-bayta. Hadha in jarun, hadha al-bayti. Same with hadhi. Hadhi al-baytu, hadhi al-bayta, hadha al-bayti. So in other words, we can see the hadhi is in which hal. The hadhi is either going to be in nasb or jariya, but we know nasb is maf'ulun bihi. So وَيَأْكُلُ, when you see هَذِهِ الْبَقَرَاتِ, yeah, this is the مَفْعُولٌ بِهِ. And what was eaten? These cows. These so what cows. Are these going to, what is the most recent to these?
The fat ones.
Seven fat ones. And ate the seven fat ones. They didn't eat, they were eaten. Mm. Who ate them? سَبْعُ, there's the ثَاعِل.
Yeah.
Seven. Baqaratin, cows, ijafin.
Lean cows. Yeah.
Seven lean cows. So the translation is, and well, if I don't do that directly, it will be to make it easy to understand. And seven thin cows ate these cows. But if you do it word for word, and eating in his dream, yes. Eating in his dream, these cows, seven thin cows ate them in the dream. I'm not too worried about your exact translation. I'm worried about you understand the sentence structure and what it means. You guys okay there? Because it is a sound female plural, not jar nafs. Yes, because sound female plural, remember, muslimatun, muslimatin, muslimatin. Now, is it next one, inshallah? Wara'a al-maliku sab'a sumbulatin khudrin wa sab'a sumbulatin yabisatin. Wara'a. And so, al-maliku, the king saw, sab'a sumbulatin khudrin. Seven, what's
green.
Ears of corn or ears of wheat. They saw seven green ears of wheat. Wasaba'a sumbulatin. And he saw seven ears of wheat or corn. Yabisatin. Dried out. In other words, he saw like in his dream, he saw seven cones of wheat that were green and fresh and lush. And then he saw seven cones of green that were like dried out and brown and so on. Ta'ajjaba, what's it? Ta'ajjaba al-maliku min hadhihi ru'ya al-ajibati wa sa'ala julasa'ahu an ta'wili ru'ya. So ta'ajjaba is which bab?
The fifth bab.
Ta'ajjaba, to be amazed, to be perplexed or confused also about it. So ta'ajjaba al-maliku, the king was, let's say, was astonished min hadhi ru'ya, from or by this dream al-ajiba, amazing or strange
amazing dream.
Wa sa'ala, and he asked julasa'ahu.
He sits down with advisors, probably.
He's advisors.
Julasa'ah is going to be the plural of a jalis. A jalis is someone who sits with you. It's in other words, like an advisor. Because if you're like the king, and then you sit there and you have your people sit around you. So the plural of those advisors are going to be julasa'ah. Literally means the people who sit with you. The people who sit with you, like your attendees or your, and so on. So he asked julasa'ahu, he asked his attendees, an ta'wili ru'ya.
About
the interpretation of the dream.
About the interpretation of the dream. Qalu, altogether, let's read. Qalu, hadha laysa bishay'in. An-na'imu yara ashya'a kathiratan la haqiqata laha. Qalu, they say, what is it?
This is not anything.
It means hada, this laysa is not bishayin, with anything. In other words, this is not anything. Meaning what? This is not anything profound. An-na'imu,
the sleeper,
yara, he sees ashya'a kathiratan.
A lot of things.
Ashya'a things, kathiratan, many things. La haqiqata laha.
But there's no truth in it.
There's no reality, there is no truth in it. The statement there is not untrue, because people do have dreams that there's no reality to it. The Prophet also called it those dreams are the dreams of the hadith of nafs. Meaning what? Generally, like if you're occupied with something, then you often dream about the thing. And that's fine. That's a part of a category of dreams. But there's also a category of dreams also, which is considered to be from Nubuwa. Meaning what? That I think the hadith says, I think a true dream in Mr. Chicken, I think is 146th of Nubuwa. A true dream, again, I think it's 146th. What I'm saying is that a true dream is 146th of Nubuwa, because one of the qualities of a prophet is that Allah sometimes gives a prophet with true dreams and dreams of which is unseen, which means that something you dream something's going to happen and actually happens. And the Prophet says this gift is given to people as well, that Allah will give people true dreams. Like the king is having, he's having a true dream now of something which is going to happen, of a famine going to happen. So we actually believe in the idea of of true dreams. And maybe some of you had some true dreams. Now, before I get married, I saw your husband in a dream, and it feels like they're married. Yeah. Happened to my wife, actually. My wife was, she met someone, and someone proposed to her, and she went istikhara, and she dreamt about me. So I always said that I'm the man of your dreams. So you can have a true dream, but it's part of. But also, I think with istikhara is a, I think there's maybe a misconception. You're not looking for a dream in istikhara. People that come make istikhara looking for a dream, like waiting for the dream. Istikhara just means on the 10th bar. Istikhara means talabul khair. Khair means goodness, and talab means seeking. It means that you're seeking Allah's answer towards goodness. So istikhara can even just be a contentment of the heart. It can just be like a settling of the heart, and also just also a process you go through in terms of eliciting Allah's help. You don't always have to wait for a dream or, you know, I'm waiting for a dream. You also have to then decide afterwards, you know, based on what your feeling is. No. ولكن بسم الله ولكن قال الساقي لا بل أخبركم بتأويل هذه الرؤيا ولكن
however
قال الساقي قال الساقي
said the wine server
كبير الساقي is just the one who basically gives people water or drinks. الساقي someone who gives someone water or drinks. Yeah, you'll find that sometimes even you go on Hajj also, you get the saqi or umrah, someone there who you know, this they have this backpacks now with the, is it Zamzam backpacks or water backpacks, and they give you, and some countries also have tea like that, like carrying a tea and they pour it and they give you, it's called a saqi. So the king had basically like a tea lady, a tea man, a drinks man. A bartender has very bad connotation, so we just say Saqi, the person who gives drinks. La, he says what? La, no. What do you say no to?
Rather.
It's a dream that there's no significance. Bal, rather, ukhbirukum.
I will inform you.
I will inform you. Ukhbirukum is on the what verb? What is that verb?
The fourth verb.
What's the
first person?
Mudari. Akhbara yukhbiru. We go all the way down. Ukhbiru. Ukhbiru. So ukhbiru is mudari fourth verb. I will inform you bi ta'wili hadhi ru'ya. Be with or regarding ta'wili. The interpretation of
this dream.
The interpretation, because Mudaf Nilay, of this dream. Wadahaba, altogether. Wadahaba Saqi ila Sijni, Wasa'ala Yusufa, an ta'wili ru'yal Malik. Wadahaba.
And
Saqi, the Kapira went ila Sijni.
To the prison.
To the prison. وَسَأَلَ يُوسُفَ and he asked Yusuf أَنْ تَعْوِيلِ لِرُؤْيَا الْمَلِك
about
the interpretation of the dream of the king. Let's dream of the dream of the king. It's inshallah. كَانَ يُوسُفُ كان يوسف جوادا كريما مشفقا على خلق الله فأخبره بتأويل. كان يوسف يوسف was جوادا جواد
generous
كريما
noble
مشفقا
compassionate
على خلق الله
upon Allah's creation.
Upon the creation of Allah. Akhbarahu.
So he informed him.
Akhbarahu, what is the fourth verb?
What
is the fourth verb? Akhbarahu.
So the Mahdi. Oh,
then he informed him bita'wil.
Yeah. About the interpretation.
About the interpretation. وَكَانَ يُوسُفُ جَوَادًا كَرِيمًا لَا يَعْرِفُ الْبُخْلَ. وَكَانَ يُوسُفُ
يوسف was جَوَادًا
generous, كَرِيمًا
noble,
لَا يَعْرِفُ الْبُخْلَ
and did not know miserliness or greed.
Stinginess.
Why are they mentioning so much this generosity of Yusuf? But why are they mentioning this specifically here? No, he didn't in the jail. Tell me about the kapir. I don't know if they mentioned the story or they mentioned the Quran, but they mentioned the story that when he, remember this kapir was actually where? He was in the prison before. He's the one who made da'wah in the previous thing. And he gave the kapir instruction. You know what? Tell the king about to find out about my case. And he forgot about it. Yes, so that's why the cupbearer is coming back now. But he didn't do it. I mean, Yusuf asked. He's like, maybe, and this is like years later. So years later, he comes back. Oh, I mean, Yusuf, it's me again. So what you'd expect? You'd expect what? You'd expect Nabi Yusuf to withhold and say, first consult on my matter before I'm going to Tell you the interpretation. But Nabi Yusuf doesn't do that. He gives him the interpretation. Therefore, he's jawad. Meaning what? Even though the kapira forgot about him, even though he can use his skill as a bargaining chip, he doesn't, because he has his mushfiq, he's compassionate, he's generous, and he's going to give the interpretation. فَأَخْبَرَ Bismillah. فَأَخْبَرَ يُوسُفُ بِتَأْوِيلِ وَدَلَّ عَلَى التَّدْبِيرِ فَأَخْبَرَ
So Yusuf informed.
What did he inform? بِتَأْوِيلِ
About
the interpretation.
He told him that this dream means there will be 7 years of plenitude and 7 years of famine. وَدَلَّ Dalla means what? To show or to indicate from the word dalil,
yeah.
Or to point to, like evidence. And he pointed ala tadbir.
Upon tadbir? The solution.
Solution or the management of the issue. Like tadbir is the solution or the management of the issue. Now, how to deal with this? Meaning, what his advice was, you must store the grain in the plentiful years, and you can use it in the famine years. Qala, he said. Altogether, قَالَ تَزْرَعُونَ سَبَعَ سِنِينَ وَاتْرُكُوا مَا حَصَدْتُمْ فِي سُنْبُلِهِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِمَّا تَأْكُلُونَ So this is the tadbir. This is the solution, the management of the issue that he told the... He didn't only give the interpretation. He also gave the how to deal with this. I must deal with it. قَالَ He said, تَزْرَعُونَ
You will plant
sab'a sinin. You will farm
for 7 years.
7 years of abundance, lots of rain and everything. Plant abundantly. Tazra'una sab'a sinin means plant abundantly for 7 years. Watruku ma hasadtum. Watruku and leave. Utruk on the first
part.
And leave. Like, don't eat it up. And leave ma hasadtum. What's hasadtum? That which
you harvest.
Fi sumbulihi.
In its covering.
In its covering or in its ear. I don't know too much about grains, but grains come in like in a sheath.
Oh.
So you keep it in the sheath, so it keeps it fresh. Don't take it out from the sheath. Illa qalilan. So leave it in its sheath, in its covering, in its ear. Illa qalilan. Except
for a little.
Mimma ta'akulun.
Which you will eat.
In other words, like you must plant abundantly, but eat a little bit because you're preparing for the famine. وَيَقُونُ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ قَحْطٌ عَامٌ تَأْكُلُونَ فِيهِ مَا خَزَنْتُمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا ويكون بعد ذلك ويكون and they will be بعد ذلك after
widespread.
Widespread. There will be a widespread drought and famine. We know there will be no rain, there will be no produce, no food, the animals have no food to eat. So what are you doing in after that? Ta'akuluna. You must eat in it. What means what?
In it.
You must eat in it. What must you eat?
What you stored.
That which you stored. Illa qalila.
Except for a little.
Eat on that, but eat it all up. Keep some for. Back up now.
Later.
وَيَطُولُ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ وَيَطُولُ هَذَا الْقَحْطُ إِلَى سَبْعِ سِنِينَ وَيَطُولُ to extend.
To last, prolong.
To last, to prolong, or to extend.
Yeah.
The tool of something is the length of something. And the length of it, the extension of it, of هَذِي الْقَحْطُ, of this, this drought and this famine will be إِلَى to سَبْعِ سِنِينَ. 7 years. وبعد ذلك altogether. وبعد ذلك يأتي نضر ويصيب الناس. وبعد ذلك.
And after that.
After that.
يأتي نضر.
The help will come.
Will come the help.
نضر النصر. What's نصر? The help of Allah will come. ويصيب الناس.
People will prosper.
And people will prosper. Mr. Kadur Khasab, the clear? If you don't know the word, look it up. خصب so the خصب yeah means to be fertile to خصب means to make fertile اسمون means fertility abundance plentiness خصب means fertile no music addiction you clear Now, akhsab means to be abundant and so on. Now, وَيُخْسِبُ النَّاسُ just means that people will have plentiful. Like things will be fertile, people will be fertile, meaning what? People will have abundance of rain and growth and so on. وَذَهَبَ السَّاقِ وَذَهَبَ السَّاقِ وَأَخْبَرَ الْمَلِكَ بِتَأْوِيلِ رُؤْيَاهُ وَذَهَبَ السَّاقِ وأخبر الملك
and inform the king.
Inform the king بتأويل رؤياه.
About the interpretation of the dream of his dream.
Okay. MashaAllah. Enjoying the translation?
No. Hard work.
Amun. You can check whenever you're unsure about the root, if there's an alif, you can just put a waw there first. If you don't find the waw, you put a ya there. So the question is, what is the root letters of amun? So if it's an alif, you won't generally won't find it there with alif. You put a waw first. No, so awama is the root letters. Awama. No. Any other questions? It's hard work, but it's good. You and then I think like as you do more, you're gonna find that you get more of it right. At first, maybe you get total confusion, and then as you get more and more, you get more of it right because you get used to the sentence structures. Now the volume of the reading is important, so you get like you internalize the Arabic sentence structures and phraseology and so on. It becomes easier and easier. So I can ask for homework, inshallah. The next chapter is too short, so you can do 14. And you can do 15, inshallah. It's not too long. 14 and 15 for homework. Chapter 14, chapter 15 for homework, inshallah.